so I don't believe a word of it. I know someone else who made up stories like that. His name was Hary Janos. Harry's friends always knew if his stories weren't true, for whenever Hary lied, he sneezed. Have you ever heard an orchestra sneeze? Well, here's the orchestra. Listen.
Hary Janos began to tell another of his tall stories. This one happened when he was a young man on sentry duty at the border between Hungary and Russia. It was warm and sunny in Hungary. But in Russia, it was always cold and snowing. One day, an old woman arrived at the border.
Yes, you cannot cross the border without more documents.
The old woman begged the Russian guard to let her through. And her begging is described with sliding sounds on the bassoon, and the viola. Listen for those begging sounds as the orchestra plays more of the old woman's music.
Bassoon and viola, playing the old woman's begging music. But although she begged, the Russian guard wouldn't let her pass. Even the Empress Marie Louise of Austria had spent all day in the Russian guardhouse trying to get permission to cross the border. Finally, she called for Hary Janos.
Hary Janos, at your service, your empressship. Leave it all to me.
We first hear Harry's tune played on the flute and the Hungarian cymbalum.
Hary Janos gets the Empress across the border in a most unusual way. And this is the music that goes with it. While you listen, see if you can imagine what he's doing. Strong, energetic music. And this is how Hary Janos got the Empress across the border.
Empress Marie-Louise is so grateful that she invites Hary to Vienna. He agrees to go, but only if he can take his girlfriend Ilka. The French horns have a tune which describes their journey to Vienna.
Old Hary Janos continued his extraordinary tale. When he arrived in Vienna, the entire city, and even the king himself, came out to greet him. Then the little archdukes sang a song for him. Join in and sing A, B, C, D with the archdukes. The king told Harry that Vienna was the musical center of the world, and that even the clocks were musical. High up on a tower, a magnificent clock began to chime. Quiz time. I want you to listen again to some of the music we've heard today and tell me which character or event it describes. Just to remind ourselves, first we heard the music for The Old Woman.
Then we heard Harry's tune.
Next, we heard the music for Harry Moves the Guardhouse.
Then we heard music for the Journey to Vienna.
And lastly, we heard the music describing the Viennese musical clock. Here comes one of those tunes again. Which one is it? That was The Journey to Vienna. Did you remember it? Here's some more music. Which one is this? And that's the music for The Old Woman. Try another one. Which one is it this time? Thank you. That was Harry's tune. One more. Which one is this? That was the Viennese musical clock.
Song about the clockmaker. Join in and sing. Ready? 3, 4.
The sun comes up and the sun goes down, but the hands on the clock keep going on round.
The clockmaker took some corks and gum and made a clock with a pendulum.
The sun comes up and the sun goes down, but the hands on the clock keep going on round.
The clockmaker built a
sun comes up and the sun goes down, but the hands on the clock keep going on round.
The clockmaker took some metal springs and made a clock with a bell that rings.
The sun comes up and the sun goes down, but the hands on the clock keep going on round.
Next time, we'll hear more of Hary Janos's story, and we'll find out what happened to him in Vienna.
To end today, here's the orchestra again. And I wonder if you can remember what this music is describing. Goodbye.
Goodbye. Last time, we heard part of the story old Hary Janos was telling. He'd arrived in Vienna, where everyone welcomed him, except a certain Count Bombazine. He was so jealous of Harry's popularity that he tried to make him look a fool by suggesting he should ride Lucifer, the wildest horse in the world. The French horns make the whinnying sound of the wild horse. Listen for that whinnying sound as the orchestra plays Hary Rides Lucifer.
Thank you.
While Harry rode the wild horse, Ilka, his girlfriend, fed the chickens. Join in with Ilka and sing the chicken song.
One, two, hungry birds I have to feed. Janos rode Lucifer with great success. He was more popular than ever. So Count Bombazine wrote a letter to Napoleon, Emperor of France, asking him to invade Vienna. He hoped the French army would rid him of Hary Janos once and for all. The trumpets sound the call to arms.
The French army marched towards Vienna. But Hary Janos, far from being frightened, got ready to fight the army single-handed. Do you think he won? Watch. Harry won all right. The draft from his sword blew over the entire French army, and the orchestra played this music. Listen out for that music again as the orchestra plays the entry of the French Grenadiers.
The army was defeated, but Napoleon himself had yet to arrive. The piccolos, brass, and percussion announced the entrance of Napoleon.
Thank you.
What do you suppose happened when Hary Janos came face to face with Napoleon, who, as everyone knows, was 11 feet tall?
Dieu, it is Hary Janos. We are doomed.
Just the sight of the great Hary Janos was too much for Napoleon. Hary had won again. The orchestra plays a funeral march as Napoleon slinks away. The tune is played on the alto saxophone. The funeral march begins with sliding sounds on the trombones and tuba.
The king ordered a great parade with, of course, Hary Janos as guest of honor. Everyone came out to wave and cheer. The percussion plays another march to introduce the victory celebration.
As a reward, the king offered Hary Janos half of his land and the hand of his daughter in marriage. Hary was about to accept when he heard this music. Hungarian gypsy music is played on the violins.
What did that music mean to Hary Janos? And did he accept the king's generous gifts? We'll find out next time.
quiz time. Listen again to some of the music we've heard today and tell me which character or event it describes. Just to remind ourselves, first we heard the music for Harry Rides Lucifer.
As Napoleon's army marched towards Vienna, we heard the entry of the French grenadiers.
Next, we heard music for the entrance of Napoleon.
Then we heard the victory celebration.
And lastly, we heard the Hungarian gypsy music. You'll hear one of those tunes again. Listen carefully and tell me, which one is this? That was the victory celebration. Did you recognize that music? Try another one. Which one is this? And the answer? The gypsy music. Try another one. Which one is it this time? The entrance of Napoleon. And one more. Which one is this? That was Hary Rides Lucifer.